A disease-modifying drug or disease-modifying treatments are the same thing. So some people refer to it as DMT, others to DMDs. A disease-modifying drug is usually given to people with relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis to slow down the relapses, to prevent the relapses from happening. And also in some cases, they slow down progression. There is now, however, a drug for primary progressive MS, the new drug Ocrevus, which has recently been released. So if you're not sure about disease-modifying treatments and whether you may be eligible for these, the best person to contact is your consultant neurologist or your MS specialist nurse if you have access to them. Otherwise, go through your GP and get a referral into the MS system. By being reviewed by the specialist nurses or the consultant neurologist, generally it's the MS nurse who is seeing patients regularly and monitoring the treatment that they're on. The way that we monitor whether the drug is working or not is by looking at any relapses that that patient may have. So if somebody relapses on a treatment, it may mean that the drug perhaps isn't working as effectively. It may mean that there might be a lack of adherence to the therapy. We generally undertake MRI scans. Now, they're not the be-all and end-all of ensuring that a drug is working. However, if there are new lesions that are seen on the MRI scan or progression, that again could mean that the drug isn't working. An EDSS will be looked at as well, so monitoring disability scores. So before you start on a treatment, we assess the patient and they're given a score. Maybe it's a low score of 1.52. And by recording that score on an annual basis, we will know whether progression is increasing or whether it's staying stable. If the score is increasing, again, that could mean that the patient isn't doing as well as expected on a treatment and may need considering for escalation of therapy. Generally, hair loss isn't clumps of hair that comes out. It usually is more kind of hair thinning, and people will come to clinic and they'll show you that the hair is thinner or take pictures to show that the hair has become thinner. Again, it's very individual for each specific patient, so some people will not get any. Other people will feel that, you know, when they shower, when they wash their hair, there is more hair in the plug hole. Others will say that it's just not a problem at all. Because it's such an individual thing, I would encourage patients saying that it probably will just be hair thinning. It's not going to be clumps of hair that you lose so that you've got like little bald patches. Hair will regrow generally over time. But if it continues to be problematic, then it does need reviewing with your specialists. There is, and what we would recommend, again in the first instance, make sure that it is just a flushing due to the Tecfidera and it's not a hypersensitivity or some sort of anaphylactic reaction. So again, it's best to discuss it with the MS specialist nurse, go into more detail about when this is happening, if there are any other more worrying side effects that may be occurring, or if it is just flushing post tablet. Again, it's best to document things down, so you will be given a booklet where you can monitor any side effects and chat either on the phone or face to face with the MS specialist nurse about those side effects. Sometimes altering the timing of the doses can help. In other cases, it will disappear, possibly months into treatment. However, if it is intolerable, Some people have found benefit from taking 75 milligram dose of aspirin. And again, it's best to discuss with a specialist nurse whether that would be advisable in your case. I think the recommendation is to take a short course of this low dose aspirin to see whether there are any benefits from taking that. Unfortunately, some people have given up on Tecfidera quite early on, and we don't know whether they may have these side effects may have waned during the treatment. But yes, certainly discuss it with either other patients that are on Tecfidera with your MS nurse to get more advice on that. And it's going to be very individual to that patient. And the problem with MS is you don't initially know whether the drug is working for you, because you're not going to notice any difference with your MS. It's not going to have any effect on the symptoms of your MS. It's only going to be in time where we look at relapse rate at the EDSS and the MRI scans to see how well that person is doing on that treatment. I certainly would say give it at least 6 months on a treatment before making that decision, obviously, with your clinicians on board. However, some people have had really intolerable side effects and just cannot continue on the drug because of that. So it's an individual thing, but 6 to 12 months if someone can persevere for that long. Depending on which infusion it is, either Tysabri or Crevislum Chada, it would be better to discuss your symptoms with a nurse probably before you go for that infusion. With Tysabri, we generally say if the symptoms are quite bad, just delay it for a few days, up to a week. With Ocrevus, up to now we haven't infused that many patients with the treatment. It's a relatively new treatment. But we would say if it's an infection, if it's more likely to be a chest infection, an ear infection, we wouldn't infuse the patient with an infection. We would wait until all the symptoms had allayed before infusing. So discuss it with the nurse. Depending on the symptoms, we may well delay that treatment just for a short while. Depending on which DMD, discuss it with the MS nurse, but most of the disease modifying treatments, we would say yes, it's absolutely fine to have a flu jab. It's not a live vaccine, it shouldn't have any effect on the MS and shouldn't have any effect on the DMD. With Ocrevus, again, that would need to be looked at in more detail. So although it's not a live vaccine and you shouldn't have a live vaccine with Ocrevus, discuss the timing of your flu injection with either your GP or with a specialist MS nurse. We do know that there probably are many people out there that are not on disease-modifying treatments that probably should be. The recommendation now, if people want to look at MS time matters, this recommends that people start on treatment early. Lots of people talk about progression from a mobility point of view, but that could also be progression from a cognitive point of view. Not everyone is 100% sure what a relapse is, particularly those that are newly diagnosed that may have experienced probably not many relapses. So my recommendation would be for anyone who is unsure to get in contact with their MS team, either through the GP or directly if they have access.